ready for the start of The Amazing Race. Catch the two-hour season premiere CBS Tuesday.
From New York, the greatest city in the world, it's The Late Show with David Letterman. Tonight, Mathew Broderick. From Alexander, Rosario, Dawson, and musical group Los Lonely Boys. Plus, Paul Schaefer and the CBS Orchestra. And now, Icelandic pixie, David Letterman.
Thank you. All right, I'm here. Hey, hey, hey. I know. You're hoping that the cabs are here. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Late Show. You folks are here on a great night, and I'll tell you why. Tonight here in the Ed Sullivan Theater, the entire balcony is filled with jurors kicked off the Scott Peterson trial. Get out of here. Boy, this is a show business saga that will never stop. Liza Minnelli. You know Liza Minnelli? She for a while was married to this guy, and then they got a divorce, and he claimed that she beat him up. She claimed that the reason that she was beating him up, and that's why the marriage... Well, now, Liza Minnelli's limousine driver, he's claiming that she also beat him up. And I want to tell you, there is nothing, when you think about it, nothing more threatening than a 58-year-old woman with an artificial hip. It's just crazy. Here's good news for folks touring the nation's capital. After a year of repairs, Pennsylvania Avenue, right in front of the White House, has been reopened. Yeah. However, it will remain closed to John Kerry. Still, get a leave. You ever have one of those weekends where you think, oh, should I do this? Maybe I should do that. Well, that's the kind of weekend I have coming up here. I'll tell you my conflict. One, the Star Jones wedding, or the Arafat funeral. Yeah, as you probably know by now, Yasser Arafat is dead. Damn, just when the peace process was going so well. Damn. But it was touching at Arafat's bed there in the hospital in Paris. Just before he passed away, Mrs. Arafat leaned down very close to him and whispered three words, "Where's the money?" But if you think about it now, with Yasser dead, his wife now gets the title Least Attractive Arafat. But calls were coming in from all over the world to Mrs. Arafat. Tony Blair, for example, called and expressed his sympathy. Vladimir Putin, he sent his condolences. Bill Riley called. Bill O'Reilly. And he asked what she was wearing. I'm so excited you people are in a great mood because we're going to go into the audience here at the Ed Sullivan Theater. You know why? We're going to play America's fastest growing party sensation, audience show and tell. Paul, let's go. Being here. This is audience show and tell, and we have beautiful folks from our audience, and they stand up and they show and or tell us something. And we're looking here for a Shelley Oliverson. Did I get that right, Shelley?
Oliverson.
Nice to see you, Shelley. How are you? Where are you from?
Salt Lake City, Utah.
And what do you do for a living there?
I stay home and take care of my two little boys.
How old are your little boys?
Two today.
Oh, really? And how come you're here and your little boy's at home? Well, what's the problem there?
You just got to get away when you can, I guess.
I'm sure he'll understand later. What are the kids' names?
Tanner and Jacob.
Tanner and Jacob. Go ahead and say hi to Tanner and Jacob.
Hey, boys.
Hi. Hey, now what are you kids doing up this late? It says here on your little card that you're from Salt Lake City, Utah, and they describe you as a stay-at-home mom, except not today. Currently traveling around the continent. We're playing show and tell, Shelley. What are you showing or telling us tonight?
I have something to show.
Uh-huh. Oh, good.
This is a trick my aunt taught me when I was about 13 or 14, and
okay.
It's kind of get twisted up in a broom and get myself out of it without letting go.
Okay, it's called the broomstick trick. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay, and did you bring your own broomstick?
I did not.
Anybody come in with a broomstick?
Oh, yes, we have one right here.
Pat Farmer.
Thank you very much.
Okay, and would you like something from us, a music or a drum roll or anything?
Yeah,
or
sure,
a spotter? Do you want somebody to watch it? Today is her two-year-old daughter's birthday. Is it son or daughter?
Son.
Two-year-old son, home celebrating alone. This is how his mom is celebrating. Here we go. Oh, my God. Whoa. Take a look at that. That was very impressive. Oh, my God. Kid's mom won't be home today. She injured her back. Very impressive. Come on down here, Vicki. This is Shelley from Salt Lake City. Dinner for two at Trattoria Del Arte. You'll enjoy that. Music from The Late Show and Explodopop Popcorn. Thank you very much. Nice job, Shelley. Good to have you with us. Shelley from Salt Lake City, everybody. Thank God we had a broom standing by.
Why?
I'm looking now for a Dan Rohner. Is there a Dan Rohner here?
Yeah, right here.
Hi, Dan. How are you?
Yeah, real good.
Welcome to the program. How you doing, sir? Where are you from?
From Dubuque, Iowa.
Dubuque, Iowa. And, I know nothing about Dubuque.
Oh.
Where is Dubuque located in this?
It's right along the Mississippi River at the Wisconsin-Illinois state line.
So that would be the northeastern part of the state,
exactly,
more or less?
Exactly.
Yeah. And what is the capital of Iowa?
Des Moines.
Des Moines, yeah. Des Moines and Dubuque, both French names, is that correct?
That's right.
Because of explorers, pioneers, trappers?
Yeah, Julien Dubuque was a French-Canadian, and he came and settled Dubuque.
Well, how about that? Julien Dubuque. He's quite a guy. He was on our show a couple of years ago. Fascinating man. What do you do there in Dubuque?
I work for the McGraw-Hill Companies.
Mm-hmm.
I deliver training on our computer systems to
our...
Good
for you. And you're in New York City on business, or...?
We came on Sunday for the marathon.
Oh, did you run in the marathon?
My son and I ran the marathon. And
wow.
My wife and our daughter came along with us.
And did they also run, or just you and your son?
Just me and my son.
Well, that's a nice thing that you and your son get to do that. Is this your first marathon?
It's my sixth.
Sixth marathon. Wow. Yeah.
My time was 4:09.
4:09, and is that your best marathon time?
No, my best is 3:14.
Whoa, 3:14. How did your son do?
My son was a little bit faster. He ran, my son Mike ran 3:29.
3:29, man, that's pretty good. But in 4, whatever that was, it's amazing that you were able to. And other than the sweater, what did you win?
Got a nice medal.
That's great. That sounds lovely that you and your son, did you train together?
Yeah, we did. Yeah. We had a lot of
good for you. That's
runs.
A wonderful activity. Dan, you're here tonight to play show and tell. What are you going to do?
Well, I'm going to tell you about a movie that I was in, and then I've got a clip to show you.
Okay, he's going to tell us. So this is actually both show
that's
and
right.
tell.
That's right.
Ooh. All right, tell us about the movie.
Well, the movie's Field of Dreams.
Mm-hmm.
It was shot in and around Dubuque. and I'm an extra in one of the scenes.
Oh, is that right? This is the baseball fantasy with
Kevin Costner.
Kevin Costner. Exactly. That's exactly right. And you're an extra in it.
Right.
Okay, and you have the clip of you in the film?
I do.
Okay, let's take a look. Just the two. All right, dinner for two at Rosa Mexicano. There's music from the... Paul, please, that's very depressing.
Well, so was the movie. No, no.
There's music from the show. And look,
you.
Your very own Explodopop.
That's
enjoy
right.
That.
Thank
nice.
You congratulations much. On the marathon. Thank you very much. And Roman. Pretty good.
And time for one more. Now I'm looking for a Peter Salimopoulos. Is there a Peter Salimopoulos? Hi, Peter. How are you?
Nice
good
to
you.
See you.
Am I pronouncing your last name correctly?
Salimopoulos.
Salimopoulos. Yeah. All right. And you're from Toronto, Canada?
Yeah.
How long have you lived in Toronto?
Born and raised.
It's one of the great towns in North America.
One of the best.
I say that all the time, but every time I go to Toronto, I have a wonderful, wonderful time. Isn't it great, Paul?
Yes, indeed. I agree. And, you know, he's got the poppy. As have I, commemorating
right.
Remembrance Day, Veterans Day here, Remembrance Day there.
Well, I'm glad you pointed that out. It nearly slipped my mind. Today is Veterans Day.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, and it's celebrated in Canada as Remembrance Day.
As Remembrance Day. Day, yes.
Ah, good. Right. Excellent. Yeah. Well, nice. Nice to see you commemorating that. And what do you do for a living in Toronto, sir?
I'm a banker.
Banker? Huh?
Yeah.
And what does that mean? Are you...
Basically, a variety of many things. Mm-hmm. I mean, I do anything from lines of credit, mortgages,
right.
Investing.
So when you go to work every day, you wear a coat and tie?
Either a suit and tie or just a tie and a shirt.
I see. Have you ever been locked in the vault?
A few times I had the occasion where I was locked in, but...
Really?
Yeah.
Do you actually have a big vault?
Very big.
How do you get into the vault?
Well, we have to spin a comp, an upper comp, a lower comp, and once the comps are spun, they're all shut on a timer.
Right.
Once the timer comes out, we open the vault, and we get all in there.
Well, all of you get in there, then.
All of us.
They all get in there.
We make it a big party.
And they all get in. So do you know all the combinations, or do like you know part of one, and another guy knows part of one?
They're giving me gradually, but I know a few of them. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And when you go in there, are there just stacks and stacks and stacks of cash?
Bags of money.
Whoa.
Bags of money. We're talking. We're rolling around in money sometimes, but it's Canadian, exactly.
Don't waste your time. It's Canadian. And what is the rate of exchange now?
I think it's about 1.3.
1.3. Well, what does that mean? Does it mean that the dollar is less? Valuable?
It's actually more valuable now. It's getting a little bit higher, but the American dollar is more valuable.
I see. Okay.
So, yeah.
All right. Now, and you enjoy that kind of work, then?
I do. I like it, actually.
Have you ever been robbed? Ever been knocked off?
Never. Thank God.
Yeah. All right.
No.
Well, Peter, welcome to New York City on Veterans Day. And what are you going to do for us? Show and tell?
I have a tongue trick.
Mm-hmm. A tongue trick. Woo.
Yeah. And it's...
And your tongue trick is what, sir?
It's the Canadian tongue thumper.
You know what he's talking about, Paul?
What? I can't even understand.
Canadian tongue thumper.
Oh, well, no, I've got no idea. Possibly.
All right, I'll just stand back here, Peter. Whatever.
What does it mean?
Whenever you're ready. What music or anything?
What is it?
He's going to show us here right now.
He should know, Paul.
Yeah, here we go.
Tongue thumper. No.
Oh. Oh, my. All right. Stop it. Wildly unpleasant. Let's take another look at that. Come on down here, Vicky. Let's see what that looks like. Oh, God. It's like you've coughed up your heart.
Kind of.
Yeah. Dinner for two at Ben Benson's. You'll have a lovely meal there, sir. That's all for you.
Perfect.
And also, here's the music from the show and your very own container of Explodopop Atomic Popping
Perfect.
Corn. It's Carbolicious. Ask for it by
Thank
name.
You
Thank
much.
You very much. Nice meeting you. Good to have you here. Peter, son of Buffalo. Well, that's it. That's all we play show and tell. Matthew Broderick, Rosario Dawson, Los Lonely Boys. We'll be right back, everybody.
Mm-hmm.
You are not to leave this building.
Coming to DVD.
Your passport and visa are no longer valid.
The Terminal.
There's a man walking around the terminal in a bathrobe.
Tom Hanks.
Are you coming or going?
I don't know. Both.
The Terminal. Buy it November 23rd.
You ever feel like you're just living in an airport?
Ever since the vacuum cleaner was invented, it's had a basic design flaw. Bags, filters, they all clog with dust and then lose suction. The technology simply doesn't work. So I spent 14 years developing one that does. The Dyson cyclones create 100,000 times the force of gravity to spin the dirt out of the air, so nothing gets clogged, ever.
Introducing Mercury Mariner. Save yourself the hassle. Get two.
Critics love Alfie. Ebert and Roper give it two thumbs up. An irresistible romantic comedy. You'll love every second of it. Jude Law.
Don't kiss me again.
Alfie, rated R. Now playing.
Break out your PlayStation 2 because the newest games are right here at the Walmart Home Entertainment Department.
The intergalactic duo is back, and they're ready to take on the online universe. Wreak havoc with some of the zaniest weapons imaginable, or blast away on thrilling new vehicles. With an addictive multiplayer experience and outlandish single-player play, Ratchet & Clank Up Your Arsenal offers all new gameplay. And this time, the destruction is personal. It's Ratchet & Clank, now available at Walmart. Rated T for teen.
We've got all the cool games. Get them at Walmart, and you're going to get a cool price, too.
Subway Restaurants introduces new hot oven-toasted subs, like the Toasted Chicken Bacon Ranch Sub, toasted top to bottom and all the way through on our fresh-baked bread. A great new taste no one can resist.
That's our sub.
Dude, you gotta stop doing that.
Subway's new Toasted Chicken Bacon Ranch. Oven toasting brings out a great new taste. Great for dinner or anytime.
I just want to look at it.
Subway. Eat fresh.
Out of gas?
Yeah.
Dodge Grand Caravan. The only minivan with stow and go. Another minivan first from Dodge.
Daddy just had to get a motorcycle, didn't he?
Funny, huh?
The lowest priced minivan in America, starting under $19,000.
Thank you very much, Paul, and the Paul Schaefer Trio, ladies and gentlemen.
I brought the trio along tonight.
And once again, let's just remember today is Veterans Day, and it sadly slipped my mind, and I'm glad you reminded me of it, and I hope it didn't slip anybody else's mind, and thank all of the veterans in your family and your community and across this great land of ours for giving their time and their lives in many cases.
Boy.
In support of the United States of America. Let's see the show tonight. Matthew Broderick. Oh, here's a guy. Matthew Broderick. Also, Rosario Dawson in the new film Alexander, which opens November 24th. Yep. By the way, this is the play that Matthew Broderick is in. It's called The Foreigner. He's starring in The Foreigner in current production right now. And I'm sure he'll have several interesting and amusing anecdotes about the staging of this production.
I'm sure he will, because as you pointed out, he's quite a raconteur.
Raconteur, yeah. Los Lonely Boys.
Ooh.
Oh, Los Lonely Boys. Los Lonely Boys.
They are
and
great.
You look at the CD and you think, well, honestly, how lonely can they be? They've got each other.
Each other, yeah. And they're all brothers, too.
Yeah, that's right. Maybe they don't get along.
Wow, you see? Yeah.
Those Lonely Boys. tonight was... how many folks love the show? It's called ER. It stands for Emergency Room. Yeah. Well, In the beginning, when George Clooney was the star of ER, it was this hard-hitting, gritty medical emergency room drama. And then he left to become Hollywood's pretty boy. And now they've turned ER. Every week it's just gotten stupid where, you know, it's always somebody from, like, a flying saucer crash lands in the parking lot and they have to save the life of a Martian. It's just gotten stupid.
That's what's happened to the show,
yeah.
Really.
So tonight they're trying trying to make it more realistic, and they're going to show you what happens to a patient in real time. Will he live? Will he die?
Oh.
Will he live?
Huh?
Will he die?
Oh.
Did you see the promotion for this?
No, I haven't seen it.
Very engaging. Take a look.
Tonight, on a special ER, one critical patient's case unfolds in real time, and the doctors have only 60 minutes to save him. Will they succeed? Yasser Arafat guest stars on an all-new ER, tonight on NBC.
You see? Those lonely boys.
Oh, lonely.
Those lonely boys.
Lonely.
You boys look kind of lonely. and how about Madonna?
Well, how about her?
Well, you know, here's the deal where a lot of times big stars, one of two things will happen. They'll either go to prison. Many of our top stars are in prison today.
You were mentioning that the other day, yeah.
And then the other group, they like to take political stands and make political statements.
So it's one or the other.
That's right. Huh? And Madonna, a superstar, has now released a statement concerning the war in Iraq.
Oh.
Madonna has issued a statement calling for the withdrawal of U.S. troops from Iraq. Inspired by Madonna's example, Britney Spears likewise demands a recalculation of the third quarter U.S. gross domestic product in light of the smaller-than-expected trade deficit and record-setting exports. A message from Britney Spears.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for a segment. I don't think we've ever done this before. It's called George W. Bush, What's Wrong with This Guy? You'll have to watch closely. George W. Bush, What's Wrong with This Guy? Roll it. I wonder if that has something to do with the bulge.
What did he say? Yeah, that. Yeah, ooh.
What's wrong with this guy?
we have a lovely program for you tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Matthew Broderick, Rosario Dawson, and Los Lonely Boys. We'll be right back with Matthew Broderick.
Don't miss Ray, the movie that has critics raving. Jamie Foxx has got to be an Oscar frontrunner in a film that will hopefully earn a dozen for Best Picture, Actor, Director, Costume, and Score. Ray, rated PG-13, now playing.
When you want to find her just the perfect gift, it helps to know the people who know diamonds. Zales beautiful half-carat diamond ring, just $149.99. Zales, the diamond store.
Being diagnosed with low adrenaline levels was devastating. No one ever warned me about adrenalitis, so I never saw it coming. There's times when you need adrenaline, and I didn't have it. That's when a friend who had beaten adrenalitis recommended the all-new 245 horsepower V6 Toyota Tacoma with the TRD package. Knocked it right out. That truck saved my life.
The all-new Tacoma. Now that's moving you forward.
CBS presents an original movie event the Weather Channel doesn't want you to see.
What do we ever do? Mother Nature.
Category 6, Day of Destruction, CBS Sunday.
Here's an open invitation from the experts at your Northland Ford dealer. Right now, get an 05 Explorer with a moonroof worth $850 and a $935 personal security package at no extra charge. Add that to $2,500 cash back and you save $4,285 on a loaded Explorer. Ford Explorer is the best-selling SUV in the world, and it comes with the features you need, like a personal security system, plus the features you want, like a moonroof at no extra charge, all with over $4,200 in total savings. So ask the experts about Explorer. See your Northland Ford dealer today.
Around here, neighbors depend on each other. We come together, work as one. It's the same with Touchstone Energy. Hundreds of cooperatives just like yours, working together. From Canton to Corsica, we give you the power.
When we shine as one.
Pay no money down, make no payments, and pay absolutely no interest till 2006 during Unclaimed Freight Furniture's Veterans Day Sale. Plus, all veterans receive an additional 10% off their purchase.
That's right.
If you proudly show your veteran's ID, you'll receive an additional 10% off. Hurry in today for incredible savings, including your choice of secretary desks, now only $179. A microfiber sectional, only $599. And a complete four-piece youth bedroom, as low as $399. It's the Veterans Day Sale. It's going on now, only at Unclaimed Freight Furniture. In Sioux Falls, Mitchell, Yankton, and Watertown.
Our first guest is a two-time Tony Award winner starring off-Broadway in a play entitled The Foreigner. Take a look at this right there. It's currently running at the Roundabouts, Laura Pell's Theater. Here's Mathew Broderick, ladies and gentlemen.
Good.
Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
Let me ask you a question. Every now and then, frequently, I'll see this movie, Ferris Bueller's Day Off. Now, you were in that, right?
Yes.
You were Ferris Bueller. And since that movie, you've been on this show many, many, many times. And I just have to say, you really don't look any older than you do when you were in Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Yeah. Well, I feel older.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, obviously you are older, but I mean, you have the good fortune. Well, we know we all grow older. But you have the good fortune to remain youthful looking.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you. We probably talked
about this also before, but there's the great scene where the Ferrari, they're trying to run the miles off the Ferrari. And the guy goes nuts and just kicks it, and it backs right out through the house and is destroyed. Now, that wasn't a real Ferrari, was it?
That was a kit car. It was some kind of Ford with a plastic Ferrari glued to it.
That's right. Is a car phonied up to look like a Ferrari?
Exactly.
Yeah. But if it had been the real, if it had been the real thing, that would have been like a $5 million car.
They had a real one for some close-ups that was about $250,000.
Right. And did you get to drive that car?
The real one?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
I got to drive the Ford with the plastic Ferrari glued onto it. And it often didn't start.
Is there?
So we did countless scenes where we'd be like, come on, let's go to the next fun adventure.
God. Wouldn't go.
Go again.
Now, speaking of films and your film career, you also did a film called The Freshman with Marlon Brando.
Yeah.
Recently passed away.
Yeah.
What was it like working with Marlon Brando? He must have been intimidating at some level.
It was very intimidating, but it was one of the most fun times I ever had. To act with him and just to talk with him and just even to... I remember the first time that I met him, we were all rehearsing the director's apartment, and he was a little bit late, and we were all pretending not to be nervous that Marlon Brando was coming, and soon enough, you know, the doorbell rang, and we all crowded around the door, opened, and he was on his hands and knees apologizing, and he was in for being late, and he was in a velour sweatsuit, with sunglasses, and a cowboy hat.
Pretty good first impression to have.
It was pretty amazing.
And
sometimes I think I might have imagined the cowboy hat. For historical accuracy, I would like to point that out.
And
I'm positive.
Could you have actual casual interaction with him?
Oh yeah. After a while, yeah. He was a very entertaining person. I remember we were at a party, a cast party, and there was a woman who walked by him a few times, and he said, "Oh, that is a beautiful ass." And I said, "Oh yeah, it is." And he kept saying it. And then I said, "It's on the big side, you know." And he said, "You want that? You want that abundancy?"
My memory
of the greatest actor who ever lived.
And at that point in his career, was he still consumed with acting or not so much? I mean, was he deadly serious about his acting or a little more relaxed?
Well, he was, you know, he would talk like he wasn't very concerned about acting anymore. But when I was acting with him, I thought he was like a laser. Mm-hmm. He was just totally consumed with it and just thrilling to act with. Yeah. He had his lines different play. Everybody knows those things.
But that's also one of those films that from time to time people will quote or remember scenes from. It's a movie that made a real strong impression for people.
Yeah, I was very proud of a lot of it. And then of course, people would say, I like the lizard. It's a good lizard. Yeah, he was good. Thank you. Yeah. I lost touch with him. But
how's your son?
My son is great.
Two years old.
He turned two, and Harry turned one.
Now we're talking to a woman in the audience about her son. Today is her son's second birthday. She's here, of course.
Yeah.
And her son is alone in daycare celebrating by himself.
Two little candles.
Yeah. But. Where's Mama?
Mama.
Mama's on TV. She's on TV. That's right.
Yeah. That's like our, yeah.
But is there, like I said, the first year for me has been fantastic.
Yeah.
Is everything okay the second year?
Yeah, it's good. You know, like there's some challenges.
For what?
Well, like the running after them part. And then in our son's case, the why.
Why?
Like he'll say, why did you come in the door?
Uh-huh.
I said, because I wanted to come into this room.
Yeah.
Why? I needed to get something. Why? Because I just need to have this pad to go in the other room with. Why? And you find, by the end, I was like, I don't know why. I don't know why I am who I am. Yeah. I don't know. I just feel totally empty. Like, I realize how little I know. I don't know why.
But Is he doing that? Is that genuine, or is he just screwing with you?
I think he's screwing with me. You know what he said to me the other day? I was leaving the house, and I said, okay, I got to go to work now. Why? Just because that's where I go. I always go to work, so I'm going to work. And he said, and he had his juice cup with him, and I said, okay, goodbye, pumpkin. And he said, goodbye, little man.
That's pretty good.
I left and I thought, is he making fun of me? Is that a joke? What is that? Goodbye, little man. Yeah.
How's your lovely wife, Sarah Jessica Parker?
Beautiful.
Yeah. What is she up to?
She's,
can I ask you that? Or I'm always nervous. Can I ask her about you? Can I ask you about her?
Yeah.
It works okay that way?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
I think, you know. I mean, to a point.
Yeah.
Nothing personal.
No, I understand. But she's. Yeah. What is she doing? Can you answer that?
I can't. I'm not at liberty. she's very busy. She's actually lately been. One of the things she's doing is working on a perfume, actually, which has been. She's been enjoying. She's picking scents and things.
Why?
I don't know. Because she likes it.
But a lot of people do this.
Yes, it's a thing, but she's always wanted to. Mm-hmm. I hope I'm not, springing the new, but she has always wanted to. So they pick the, they give her all these potions and she loves it. And shapes for bottles, which I believe, I'm not giving up too much, is going to be in the egg family.
Oh, the shape of the bottle.
Will be.
It's always very, very important, the shape.
I know.
Yeah.
I know. They might switch that. You never know. But at the moment, it's...
And have you sampled any of the fragrances? Do you know what she's looking at or smelling?
No. I was going to make an egg to smell like eggs joke.
Oh, I see. Yeah,
I don't feel it now.
That's not good.
thank you. Why? I could just say why.
Yeah.
What if I came out here and just said why to you for 10... Wouldn't you be driven...
Well, you wouldn't come back.
Yeah.
It's as simple as that.
Why?
Yeah.
I haven't sampled. She's an amazingly. She smells. She is great. She just really knows how to pick perfumes.
No, I know. Whenever she's.
She smells great.
Yeah,
guys.
Whenever she's on the program, it's just lovely.
Because, right?
Yeah, olfactorily speaking, it's a wonderful. Wonderful presentation.
It is.
Yes, fantastic.
I know.
But let's talk a little bit about The Foreigner here.
Okay.
This is an old play that's being remounted. Is that how they talk in Broadway?
Yes.
Yeah.
And it smells like pine.
And it's about a man who
it's about a man
doesn't speak English or does speak English?
He does speak English, but he's been through a trauma and doesn't want to talk to anybody. So he comes up with a thing where he doesn't. They don't know that he speaks English. So people talk around him.
I see.
And he gradually develops his own foreign language, and then they gradually teach him English.
Uh-huh. And, so, and he's vacationing? He's on a retreat?
He's vacationing in a retreat to get over a heartbreak.
I see.
And he's in Georgia, in a rural part of Georgia. Let's go to a clip.
All right, take a look. But now, do you have a lot of dialogue in this show? Or
I
not
have
much?
A lot later, but in the early scenes, I'm pretty quiet, mm-hmm. which is nice for me. I mean, it's an interesting acting exercise to not speak and yeah. just listen and be there.
Yeah.
And also, as the run has progressed, I've learned that if I look as though I'm listening, but really go through some of the items of my day and what needs to get done tomorrow, that's also very effective. So I can multitask with this role.
that's great. How long will you be in the production?
Till January 16th.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Good.
Yeah.
And have we talked about this before? Are you and your wife working on stage together? Has that happened in the past?
We did How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying a long time ago.
Yeah.
96, I think. And I don't know. It would be nice.
It would be good because it seems like you're always off doing different things. It would be nice if you had a common project on which to work.
Yeah. I know.
Yeah.
Can you think of anything?
Well, no, it's
not your job.
Not up to me, no.
No,
for heaven's sake.
It's not your job.
You figure it out.
Okay. Why?
All right. Always a pleasure. Give my best to your family.
Thank you very much.
Mathew Broderick, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with Rosario Dawson.
The number one movie in America is absolutely incredible.
Showtime.
Critics unanimously agree. The Incredibles is the year's best movie so far, and by far.
Coincidence? I think not.
Disney presents a Pixar film. Two thumbs up.
You're experts.
For The Incredibles, rated PG, now playing.
You have reached the county clerk. For a business license, please press 1 now. For a fishing license, press 2 now. For a fishing license, press 2 now. For a fishing license, press... For a fishing license, press 2 now. Please hold. Ingwit the queen of hot arts. Knowing it ain't really smart.
Sometimes a small business owner needs to talk to a real person. The City Business Card, with real live small business specialists on the phone. That's a card you can count on.
At GMC, we know that payloads don't need to stretch their legs, listen to XM satellite radio, enjoy dual climate control, or watch DVDs. But people do. Introducing the new GMC Sierra 1500 Crew Cab. Professional-grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
Tryptophan. The amino acid in turkey which causes extreme sleepiness. Known antidotes for tryptophan. Trip to Caribbean. Trip to Alaska. Trip to Europe.
The Royal Caribbean Family Cruise Sweepstakes is going on right now. 3 grand prize winners get an amazing cruise vacation for 12. And we're giving away a lot more than that. Just check out RoyalCaribbean.com to sign up and win. What are you waiting for? Get out there.
This man thinks the orange juice he's drinking will help lower his cholesterol. This man knows Minute Maid HeartWise is clinically proven to do just that. Because only Minute Maid HeartWise contains added cholesterol reducers. Minute Maid HeartWise, for your one and only heart.
The Emmy Award-winning Amazing Race is back. Get ready.
These rocks are loose.
For the ultimate adventure.
See ya!
Don't miss the Amazing Race 2-hour season premiere, CBS Tuesday.
Get hooked and get happy with Mid-Continent Communications. Sign up for Mid-Conet high-speed internet now and pay just $14.95 a month for a limited time. It's the fastest internet in town with a constant connection, no tied-up phone lines, and virus protection. Only from Mid-Continent Communications.
Make you happy. Make you happy.
If you're looking for 17 different models,
Toyota's got it!
And if you're also looking for incredible values,
Toyota's got it!
Lease one like a Camry, Corolla, or Highlander. And right now you can lease a legendary Camry for only $199 a month. Or lease the number one selling compact car in America, Corolla, for just $169 a month. There's also a $229 lease on Highlander, rated an excellent value. Toyota Value. Now that's moving you forward.
Break out your PlayStation 2 because the newest games are right here at the Walmart Home Entertainment Department.
Kickstart your PlayStation 2 with the off-road excitement of ATV Off-Road Fury 3. Roam over 40 different tracks against up to 6 players online. Experience adrenaline-rushing tricks and effects so realistic you'll have to wipe the mud off your face. Blaze your own trail with ATV Off-Road Fury 3, now available at Walmart, rated E for everyone.
We've got all the cool games. Get them at Walmart, and you're going to get a cool price, too.
Our next guest is a talented young actress is starring in a new motion picture entitled Alexander. It opens November 24th. Here's the lovely Rosario Dawson.
Thank you, so do you.
That's a beautiful dress.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now, I always like to ask this. You're so nicely, lovely dressed. Does that mean you're going somewhere after the show?
No, it's for you.
Oh, thank God.
I swear it's for you. I'm so excited to be here.
Well, we're
I love
very excited
you.
To have you here.
Thank you.
Now, moments before you came out, someone said to me, you know, this woman, in addition to other things, recently, went to Spain, to Pamplona, and participated in that madness with the bulls. Is that...
Running with the bulls in Pamplona,
is
yes.
Is that true?
Yes.
Yeah. First of all, why do they do that? Do they only do it one time a year?
Yeah, it's a once-a-year thing. They do it for a few days, and right now it's sort of bombarded with a bunch of people coming in just to be drunk and run and be stupid. But
right.
it did have, like, a beautiful tradition. We all wore white and the red sashes to bring more attention to yourself, which felt very stupid when I was running in there. I'm glad I didn't get a horn colonic by the end of it. But.
Whoa, a horn. Hello.
New medical term.
But what drew you to the event?
I was traveling in Spain, and it was something I'd thought about doing, and they had allowed women to do it for the past few years, and I don't know, I always try everything once, so after that I went skydiving, which wasn't nearly as exciting.
It wasn't as exciting.
No, I mean, I was perpetually scared after Pamplona, yeah. So.
And how long must you run to stay ahead of the bulls? How far is it, like a mile, a quarter mile?
Well, you really can't stay, once they start and you can't get ahead of them, they're really, really fast.
Right.
But you can start off a little bit further into it, so you can get into the arena before they all get in, because once they all get in, you can't be a part of the festival anymore.
And so they're running them from their point of housing to the bull fighting arena?
Yeah, it's crazy. The diehards are the ones who are, like, right next to the gates that open up, which are really, really crazy. And then, the streets get narrower and narrower. And I got grabbed into a doorway by someone. And I thought for a second it was chivalrous, but in actuality, they were probably just trying to block being hit themselves, which is kind of scary. I was like, thanks, but no thanks. It was a very good moment to have grown up in New York, because there was a lot of, like, dodging and getting through that I needed to do. It was like, okay, it's crowded and it's raining. Let's just think about
like
that.
A good excuse for an easy grope is what it sounds like.
It wasn't a kind of doorway.
Other than that, no incidents then, huh?
No, not really. I did hike myself up. I don't know how far it was, but there was one point where there were more bulls coming. And I guess they put a couple of females in there with clanging bells so that they can kind of, if the bulls get separated, they'll keep moving them forward. And so I kept seeing bulls coming down. I counted 5 already, so I was like, why are there still more here? And people were still running and screaming. So I must have jumped up on some, like, fire escape thing and pulled myself up. I was like She-Man for a second there. It was pretty amazing.
Wow.
I was like, what's going on? Kicking people out of my way. You get really, like, massive amounts of strength all of a sudden. It was pretty good.
And when you want to do this, I mean, do you just do it or do you have to sign up, or is it like the marathon? You got to get a number.
No, you just do it. You get in there. You got to get there like 8 o'clock in the morning, or what was it, 6 o'clock in the morning? I don't really remember. And you get in there really early. But once the gates close, you can't leave.
Mm-hmm.
They're like police there, people on the rafters and stuff. And it's like you're in there, and there's a point where you can do. But once they start, they start the mission. It's suddenly like you can't go. You might have just got scared because now they're about to do it, but you can't leave. Now we're just gonna watch. It's like, ooh, okay.
And start to finish, how long does this event last?
It felt like hours. But it probably was just a few seconds. I mean, it was like about 2-3 minutes of actual like running, or maybe longer.
Yeah, but I can see where it would seem like much, much longer.
Yeah.
But thrilling.
Thrilling, nonetheless.
Very exciting.
I was perpetually scared for 3 months afterwards. I'd step off a curb and think I was going to break something. Yeah. Like, everything kind of shook me up after
but,
that.
But a memory for a lifetime, certainly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's talk about the film, Alexander the Great. Is that what we're talking about here?
Yes.
Yeah. And where was this filmed, the movie?
We shot in Morocco, Thailand, and in London. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was pretty amazing. It was really beautiful. It was very epic in like the grand scale. There were actual camels and, you know, horses and elephants, and it was really, you know, big Thai mosquitoes. It was really, really amazing.
Big Thai mosquitoes.
It was amazing. It was sort of like, geez, okay.
And what did you learn about Alexander the Great? That first of all, he was like 27, right, conquering the world at 27 years old.
Yeah, he was crowned king at 20 years old. It's pretty amazing, you know, how our youth was totally used differently then, mm-hmm. and our elderly were also, and our elders were also used differently. The people in like 65 years old were out there fighting and decapitating people and fighting wars. It was like a total, and there was no pension plans really then. Like they have now. It's like, you're still useful.
I didn't realize people lived to be that old in those days.
They did. There are a few that very much did. They were not the kings usually. Yeah. They kind of got kicked out pretty early.
And in this adaptation, this portrayal, Alexander is Colin Farrell?
Colin Farrell, yeah.
How's this guy?
He's amazing. He's really great.
Because he seems to me like he would be troubled.
No. He's extremely wonderful, and he did such a great job in this movie. It's a very complex character, as Oliver wanted to look at it. Oliver Stone's a director, and he didn't want to do sort of like a biopic kind of boring thing with details. There's very little extant anyway historically about him, so might as well just kind of make it about his character. So it's like a raging mother and father and his more personal issues kind of coming up. So he doesn't name it Alexander the Great, it's Alexander. It's up to you to figure out if you think he's great or not.
And for many actresses, this contained a scene in which you're undressed, naked.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. you see, I could never do that. I don't even like being naked at home.
No.
But how does that work? Because it's everybody, it's teamsters and guys just hanging around. When's the scene?
I know.
Pretty much what it is.
There are a lot more people on the crew suddenly that day.
But you must be terribly self-conscious about that.
No, actually, when we were rehearsing it, we made it what it is now.
So, no, when
which is very intense.
When you rehearse a naked scene.
We didn't rehearse it naked. Though.
You don't rehearse it naked.
No, I think that's
good.
And I brought a knife to rehearsal, which he ended up using in it anyway. I'm tough, man. I gave Colin a black eye when we were doing the scene. It was like, go ahead, smack me. And I was like, all right, cool. Like, it was a really interesting scene. Like, he wanted to be really helpful and take off his pants during the shot. Like,
see?
I know you're naked, and maybe
exactly
we could make it more comfortable. And I was like, no.
Exactly what I was talking about. I knew.
No, I got a knife. I'm good, baby.
Let's, I want to see a clip here. Do you know what we're going to look at?
Yeah, there's a very tense relationship. There's no two people running off and happy in love and running through fields of flowers. She's kind of berating him and sort of telling him that he needs to do something else with his, with himself and his power.
All right, let's take a look. Alexander, it opens November 24th.
In Persia, you are a great king. Here, they hate you. Let us go back to Babylon. There you're strong.
We'll talk about this later.
Yes. Later. Talk.
I shall come. Tonight.
And I shall wait.
Oh. Well, it's very nice for you. Opens November 24th. Great pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you come back.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you very much. Rosario Dawson, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with Los Lonely Boys.
Critics across the country agree. Shall We Dance is pure entertainment.
Thank you. Thank you.
Just ask anyone who's seen it. It's the feel-good movie of the year.
Dance with me?
Shall We Dance, rated PG-13. Now play.
Imagine the possibilities of a child. The dreams waiting to happen. Come to McDonald's and help us support World Children's Day. Right now, give a hand to Ronald McDonald House Charities. And together, we can help children in need reach their destinies.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba, I'm loving it.
Hi, I'm Craig Ferguson, host of The Late Late Show with my guest, tennis great Venice. Venice. Hi, Venice.
The two biggest storms in history are about to collide over America. CBS Sunday.
If you build it, he will come.
Looking for a movie with style.
I'm wearing ladies' underwear.
It's a thong!
Sophistication. Drama.
Catnip.
That's no mind.
Pick up the number one selling DVD in America by Shrek 2, the biggest film of the year today.
Sunday, in 1983, Jeffrey Kern was a crusader against AIDS.
This place is a hotbed of disease.
No one knows how it spread.
His father disowned him.
I hated the way he lived.
His friends rejected him.
Stay out of my way.
But who murdered him?
You're not going to find this palatable.
Consider me warned.
A new cold case, CBS Sunday.
It's time for words of inspiration from Late Show cameraman Dave Dorsett.
No one told me anything about this. What am I supposed to say? I'm working here. A little notice would have been nice.
Thanks for those inspiring words, Dave. This has been Words of Inspiration from Late Show cameraman Dave Dorsett. Tell your friends.
That restaurant was great.
Yeah, it's one of my favorites.
Is that where you take all your first dates?
Maybe.
Oh! That girl almost hit me.
Women drivers.
Introducing the highly maneuverable Mercury Mariner.
I want you to steal me that diamond.
I'm not a criminal.
Right. Neither am I.
This Friday.
This is the next setup, isn't it?
Everyone wants a piece.
Cute little rock.
I just hit the look. No one can be trusted.
Sophie, nice gun.
And only one of them can win.
But it's not who you think it is.
I don't like those twist endings.
After the Sunset, directed by Brett Ratner, rated PG-13, starts Friday.
Honey, wake up! Time for presents!
This holiday, show her how excited you are about her. With the Leo Diamond, crafted by the artisans at Leo Schachter and hand-selected to match beautifully by Kay.
Wow!
Wow!
Every kiss begins with Kay.
Wow, stuffed chicken marsala, stuffed chicken limone. It sounds good.
Sounds good. Can you actually hear them being stuffed with four Italian cheeses? Can you hear the creamy marsala sauce? Is the limone calling?
It spoke to me, yes. Only at Olive Garden.
Tis the season.
Whoa, which card are you using? Those rates are brutal.
Our new Capital One Prime Lock Card.
The new Prime Lock Card from Capital One. It's set at prime, so you never have to worry about your interest rate again.
What's in your wallet?
Inside that digital camera is something familiar, a battery. And while you might think all batteries are the same, consider what happened here last winter when a heart stopped and his life depended on a Zoll defibrillator. And when Zoll chooses a battery, they trust Duracell. So whether it's saving a moment or saving a life, it just has to work. Duracell, trusted everywhere.
CBS Friday, it begins with a first date.
You look so beautiful.
But where it ends...
It's Joan's friend!
Only God knows.
This is the first time in my life I ever wanted to live.
I know you called the shots, but I need you right now.
A new Joan of Arcadia, CBS Friday.
December's coming.
How'd it get to be November? Where did the year go? Wasn't it just July 4th? Now it's time to cook the bird. The holidays will hit you
like a brick.
That's why this week at Old Navy,
there's a bunch of super cool sweaters
and great new styles like Fair Isle turtlenecks, beaded cardigans, and
cable nippy necks.
They sure are festive.
Exciting new sweaters starting at $19.50 this week at Old Navy.
Yes, sirree. Our next guest, wonderful rock and roll band whose new self-titled CD is currently in stores. Please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Los Lonely Boys.
Hey, Dave, we do get along, by the way, man.
When I kiss you,
the new 2005 Ford Super Duty's towing capacity with a Chevy Silverado, you better make sure you got more than one Silverado. With a class-exclusive tow command system, the new Super Duty can just flat-out pull more. And with a fully integrated trailer brake controller, Super Duty does it with more control. This is best-in-class towing. This is the next Ford Super Duty. Ask the experts. See your Northland Ford dealer today.
Go ahead. Give it a try. It's a ceiling.
So, how do you guys stay awake?
Right now, every Sealy mattress is on sale at Slumberland. Get a Sealy Pillow Top Queen Set for just $2.98. Slumberland, the best place to buy a mattress.
I've been eating these things since high school.
Taco John's awesome.
I think they put more cheese in their tacos.
The lettuce is crisp.
The beef's really good.
I like them.
Beef is excellent.
They're really good.
I'll get a six-packet a pound and end up eating the whole thing.
They make it right when you order.
The shells are great because they're nice and crispy.
The price is right, too.
This is the best taco in town.
There's a whole lot of Mexican going on.
There's a whole lot of Mexican going on in my life.
When you get the hankering for a good taco, this is where you come.
Just when you thought you'd seen it all, there comes another and another. America's hottest products are at your Chrysler dealer. Like Town and Country, with two rows of fold flat stow-and-go seating and the government's five-star side impact crash test rating. Get 0% financing plus November bonus cash for a total savings of up to $5,600 on one of America's hottest products.
Har & Lemme builds quality homes that create neighborhoods. Neighborhoods that create warmth, happiness, a place to call home. And we only choose quality materials from Frisbees, like this Carrier gas furnace with its exclusive comfort heat technology, the world leader in air conditioning, heating, and refrigeration systems. Turn to the experts with Frisbees and Carrier. Visit one of our 12 neighborhoods online at har-lemme.com. Har & Lemme Homes. If you want the best home, choose the best builder.
There are hundreds of things to worry about when you buy a new car. The promo price isn't one of them. Right now at Chevrolet of Sioux Falls, get the best new cars, trucks, and SUVs with our low, hassle-free promo price. There's always more than one in stock at the low promo price. A 2005 Chevy Cavalier promo price, $8,999. Save almost $6,000 off MSRP. We only have six in stock at this low price. Promo pricing, the easiest way to buy. Olivia exclusive from Chevrolet of Sioux Falls.
Tomorrow, Paul Rubens, Evangeline Lilly, and Project Bandaloop.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, we'll see you then. Good night, everybody.
Pants, the other white meat.